Here we go. Last one. I'll get the next set of seven slides. Not slides. My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. I love it. For Christ's sake, I delight in weaknesses, insults, and hardships, and persecutions, difficulties, for when I'm weak, then I'm strong. The best result of pain is refined character. I remember working at Rose's while I was going to college. And somehow or another, when I worked at Rose's, that big old Rose's in Washington, somehow or another, out of clear blue sky, one day I'd come in, and the head man, the manager's store, says, David, I want this done. Handle it. It's okay. So I went and told people. He said, why are you telling us to do it? I said, that's what man told me to tell you. The next day, David, I want this done. Handle it. David, I want this done. Handle it. I finally went to the guy. I said, why are you telling us what to do? I said, I have no idea. The man just told me to tell you to do it. So finally, the company said, we made you stock manager. Didn't you get notice? And then when anything had to be put together, they said, David, you go back in the back and put it together. So I had to read all those directions, put all that stuff together. I put stuff together all the time. I'm out there. Anything was put together, Roses. If you got something back when I was 17, 18, 19 years old, you got to think Roses should have been perfect. If it weren't, they had to shoot it from another Roses that weren't there. God, why is all this happening? I don't have time for this. I'm trying to go to school, I'm trying to work, I'm working two jobs, I'm working at a TV shop, I'm working here, and I'm doing two jobs. I ain't got time for all this. Now I'm in charge of all this and tell everybody everything. I got to put everything together. And it hit me the other night. I was putting stuff together at the house. But the relentless said, you know, I didn't understand it when I was going through it. It actually aggravated me, and I felt kind of taken advantage of it. I said, but every job I had after that, I got put in charge of people. And I had to put stuff together. Odors, bicycles and tricycles and games and roses. Here, it was supervising the construction of $1 million equipment, learning how to operate computers and teaching everybody else how. See, God was showing me, God was teaching me, God was training me along the way. Everything you go through, you think it may be for nothing. No, you're going to use it again later, just in a different way. Amen? So just remember this. Remember, look. This is really awesome too. Just know that this is the perfect message for today. As I was writing this, I was sitting on the couch last night, and as I was typing this, phrases coming up. We had the TV on music, because Linda was doing her test, and I was doing this, so we had music. And it put some little things across the screen from time to time. And Bethany reads this out loud while I'm typing. I thought Bethany was reading my mind and start with it, so that can't. At the same time I was writing it, life is 10% what happens to you and 90% how you respond. We get that mixed up. Something happens to us, we throw it into 90%. No, it's still 10%. Whatever happens to you, it's only 10%. 90% is how you respond to it. And a lot of times if you respond to it in the right way, you can either lessen a trial, weaken a trial, or give a trial more strength in your response to the trial. So here we go. Ready? Get ready to close. I told y'all was. Our pain enhances our contentment. Amen? I delight in weaknesses. That word delight, here it goes. That word delight means to be willing and to take pleasure. That word again, when I'm weak and I'm strong, watch this. When I'm weak, when I have impotency and unable to do anything, I'm just totally zapped. Oh, hell. But I can't do anything at all. I'm so zapped by this thorn in my flesh, I feel like I can't put one foot in front of another. Then I feel strength, the ability to do anything. God uses pain as a measure of faith. When I'm stripped of my human strength, then I can do some great and mighty things. When you're stripped of your human strength, that's what God's doing. Remember telling you about the rose bushes in the church yard? We had some rose, they're not rose bushes, I'm not good on what kind of bushes they were, but we had these bushes when I was pastoring in Benson. We had about 40 bushes all the way around the front of the church, the side of the church, around we had about 40 bushes. And they all looked terrible. Every year somebody comes through and try to cut the dead out of them. And so not only did they still have dead stuff growing in them, but at the same time you had big old holes cut in them and you couldn't even do anything, any kind of nice look for the bush because it had dead spots all in it. It kind of terrible. And I was sitting there one Saturday working on a sermon in the office and the guy comes up and says, "Pastor," and says, "Yes, sir," he says, "Can we fix those bushes for you? So they'll be very pretty next year. That'll be awesome." I said, "Sure." He said, "I got the care." I said, "I'll try to trust you. Go ahead." I'm in there working, and all of a sudden I hear, "Rum, rum, 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 rum." I said, "I heard, rum, 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 rum." I said, "Is that chainsaw?" And I said, "We don't have any trees." I said, "Our neighbor don't have any big trees. Who's got wood? They don't even burn. We don't burn wood. The church has got wood." So I get up and walk around. And I see that guy told him he was going to fix all these bushes. Put a chainsaw in his hand. He'd cut them down to the ground. He'd cut 3/4 of them down before I went out to check on them. All down and said, "Michael, what have you done?" He said, "I fixed your bushes." I said, "I could have done that. We could just tore them up with an axe." He says, "No, you don't understand, Pastor. I know what I'm doing." I said, "I hope so. We had a church tomorrow. He said, where's our bushes?" He said, "Trust me." He said, "I know the kind of bush this is. I'm cutting it down. It gets rid of all. It's look at the roots. They're all healthy. Everything's healthy." I said, "Yeah." He said, "Well, up here they're not healthy. Down here they are." So I had to cut them down to where they were healthy. And give them a chance to do it again. Next year, we had pretty bushes. They didn't have any death. Didn't have any signs of death. And they're all beautiful. We can shape around the way we want to with them. But when he was doing it, I thought he had lost his ever-loving mind. And if he didn't, all he had to say was, "The pastor said I could do it." He didn't tell me he was going to cut him down. He just said, "I'll fix it. Just let me handle it." That's how he always said, "Just let me handle it." "Okay, you handle it. I got this. All right, you got it." And then he cuts them all out. You see, this is my favorite slide of all.